Now, I made one small mistake I'd like to correct before we move on, and that is that I left the ROAS value out of my integration. ROAS does not depend on theta or phi, so I can bring it outside of my integration, which means I'm just going to have a ROAS right here, which is 2 coulombs per meter squared. Now, let's move on to our further problem. I'm actually going to make this one slightly more difficult than what I wrote originally, because I'd like you to be able to see what happens if this rho v was a function of r. So instead of being 3 coulombs per meter cubed, let's do 3r coulombs per meter cubed, which means that my charge gets larger as I get away from the center. So now let's consider the case right here where r is between a and b, and I want to find my electric flux density. My left-hand side is still going to stay the same, so the integral of d dot ds is still going to be 4 pi r squared dr. But my total charge enclosed, my right-hand side, is not going to be the same. Q is going to still include my 1 coulomb, and it's still going to include my ROAS times 4 pi a squared, which is what I calculated on the previous page, and now I need to include the part of the volume that I have picked up here with my Gaussian surface. So that part is going to be a volume integral of rho v dv, and if you look at table 3-1, dv is r, is r squared sine of theta dr d theta d phi. R in this case, just the part I'm picking up, is going to vary from a to r. Here's r right there. From a to r, theta is going to vary from 0 to pi, and phi is going to vary from 0 to 2 pi. As I do my integral, I'm going to have rho v, which in this case is 3r. That's going to get combined with my r squared here, so that when I do the dr integration, I'm going to have a 3 from my rho v, and it's going to be r to the 4th over 4 from a to r. My sine is going to go to minus cosine from 0 to pi. My phi is just going to go to phi from 0 to 2 pi, and what I'll get is 3 r to the 4th minus a to the 4th over 4 times 2 times 2 pi, and that's what's going to get added into my other q values. So I will set this right-hand side equal to this left-hand side and solve for dr. So there's the case when I'm between a and b. Now, what will happen if I am outside of b? Suppose that I am out here. So r is greater than or equal to b. In that case, my left-hand side stays exactly the same. This term stays the same, and this term stays the same. But right here, I integrate from a to b, because outside of b, there is no additional charge to add up, and I will have b to the 4th instead of r to the 4th. And that's the only change that would occur. So now we have calculated the electric flux density in every one of our regions. In the spherical case, as in the cylindrical case, our left-hand side, this part right here, is always the same. It's 4 pi r squared dr. And the right-hand side is the total charge enclosed. That's what changes. We could see that in this case, we had a unit charge, we had a surface charge, and we had a volume charge, and we had to add each of those up if they were inside our Gaussian surface.